Hello everyone, my name is Satyam Yadav. I am a software engineer at Microsoft, and in this video I'll be discussing about asynchronous programming using callbacks in JavaScript. So you can use asynchronous programming to make your website more responsive and deliver a better experience to the users. So before we dive into the code, let's first understand why we really need asynchronous programming patterns. So let's say that we had three groups of statements. There's this first group of statements which is executed fast. There's this second group of statements which is slow because it makes some request to server to get some data, and this is followed by another third group of statements which is again fast. Now JavaScript is a single threaded language, and if we were to follow the synchronous pattern only, then all the statements would act as a blocking statements. This means that the third group of statements would have to wait for the second group of statements to complete before it can be executed. So the second group of statements would go make a request to the server, wait until it gets back data, and then only the third group of statements can be executed. This is bad when the third group of statements doesn't really need the data that was requested by the second group. We can get rid of this situation by following the asynchronous pattern. Now let's dive into the code and see how we really do this. So now, in order to mock the first group of statements, I'll put a console.log statement, which would just say console.log, and hey there. So this is sufficient for the first group of statements, and for the last group of statements, I'll again put another console.log statement. And this should say adios. Let's go ahead and mock the second group of statements, which would be to get data from the server. So for this, I would create a function named get data, and I'd be using the arrow function syntax here. So this would take one parameter, which is request data. So this request data would contain all the data that is required to actually go ahead and make the request to the server. And the way arrow function works is, so I have this request data as the input parameters to this function, and whatever logic that I want to implement, that I can write within this curly braces. So since I wouldn't be making an actual call to get the response, let me just go ahead and create a variable named response data, and we would populate this with whatever value we want. So for now, I'll write data from server. So this response data would represent the data that I obtained from the server. Now let me tell you a little bit about callbacks. So simply put, callbacks are those functions that would be executed after another function has finished its execution. So let's say I decide to pass a callback to this getData function. So now, since this callback would actually be a function, and this is being passed as parameter to this getData function, so this getData would be called as a higher order function. This is possible in JavaScript because JavaScript allows you to treat functions as objects. So this callback, which would actually be a function, is being treated by JavaScript as an object, and that's why we can pass it through this to this getData function. And after this getData has finished getting the response data, we can go ahead and call this callback. Now, for this scenario, processing the data seems to be a good choice to act as callbacks. So let me go ahead and define the logic for processing the data as well. So I'll create another arrow function, and this can take the response data as one parameter, and if there are errors, then it can take the error as another parameter. And in this logic, we can write, if there's some error, then go ahead and make a console.log saying that I encountered an error. and we can also print the value that we got from error. And if there's no error, then we can go ahead and make a console.log saying all is good, and we can also go ahead and print the response data that we got. Since we are also handling error, it would make sense to put these two statements in a try block so that we can actually demonstrate error going on later, and put another catch block as well. These two statements should go into the try block. And yeah, so this process data is supposed to be the callback that would get passed to this getData function. So make sure the calls are in the right format. So this callback, which will be process data actually, would get two parameters. The first parameter would be equivalent to error. So in the try block, we don't have any errors, so the error value would be null, and we'll pass the response data. And in the catch block, we can again call the callback, pass the error that we got to this callback function, and there's no need for passing any response data in the error scenario. And yeah, so this is how the process data, which would act as callback, and the get data, which would be the actual function calling the callback, would get implemented. And let's go ahead and execute the get data. And it will take two parameters, the request data, which would be the data required for making request, and the second parameter would be the callback, which is process data. Now we can run this and see what we get as output. Yeah, so this is currently in synchronous state only. We haven't mimicked the actual asynchronous operation of getting data from server. We can do that later. For now, we can see the first console.log here, there is present. After that, we called get data with data required for making request string as the request data, and we passed the process data function as callback. And yeah, so this try block, it assigned data from server to the response data, and then it did this callback to process data with error value as null and response data as the data from server. And since the error value is null, it would go to the else part, and it will make a console.log saying all is good, and the response data is the data from server, which you can see in the second line of console.logs. And finally, console.log adios does the logging of adios. Now let's also see a scenario in which we actually encounter error. So to do that, we can manually put in a throw statement after this try block, which would say, now there can be various kind of errors. For now, I'll just write down connectivity issue. So this catch block would get error as this connectivity issue, and then call the callback. So the expected output would be hey there, which would always be there, and after that this process data would throw this connectivity issue, which would get passed along to the process data, and it will encounter an error. So it would say I encountered an error and connectivity issue after that, and finally adios. So let's see if everything's working fine or not. Yeah, so as I explained, the output is as expected. Let's comment this through a statement and see how we can actually make this get data as a function that would actually take some time to get executed. Let's say it would take 2 seconds to make a request to the server and get back the response data. So in order to do that, we'll be using the set timeout function. So the syntax for set timeout is it takes two parameters, The first parameter would be the name of the function, and the second parameter would be the delay duration in millisecond, after which you want to schedule the execution of the first parameter, which is the function that you passed. So we'd have to pass one function to this set timeout function. So let's make all the statements that are present inside this get data's body into a single function. So I'll show you how we can do that. Let's create another const that has name get data helper, and this get data helper would again be an arrow function, and this arrow function would then contain the whole of this try catch block. This would go inside this curly braces, and let's save this. Yeah, so what I did is I just assigned everything inside this get data function to another const, which is again an arrow function, and to execute this now we'd just write down get data helper and call this function. So this would give me hey there followed by all is good data from the server and adios. Let's see if it's executing properly or not. Yeah, so everything's working fine as expected again. Now let's mock the asynchronous scenario where it would take around 2 seconds to get the response data back from the server, and then we'll process the data. So to do that, let's remove this get data helper, write down set timeout, pass this get data helper as the first parameter, and the equivalent to 2 seconds would be 2000 milliseconds. So this would be the second parameter to the set timeout function. And now, can you guess what the expected output would be? So the second line, which is the first console.log statement, would get executed as usual. So you will see hey there. After that, this is just a function definition. This is again a function definition. Then there, this get data would get called. So this would pass the request data and callbacks, and then again there's one more function definition, and this set timeout get data helper comma 2000 milliseconds would schedule this get data helper function to be executed after 2 seconds. So since it's scheduled to be executed after 2 seconds, your JavaScript can go ahead and execute another line, which is adios. So you'd see hey there followed by adios, and after that your get data helper would get executed, which would perform the callbacks and the response data assignment as usual. So let's run and see if the output matches what I just told or not. Yeah, if you notice, there was a brief pause after the printing of adios because of this 2 second delay. Yeah, so this is pretty much how you use callbacks to implement asynchronous patterns. Let's just try out with the error scenario also to see if everything's working fine or not. Yes, everything is working as expected. Do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon if you want to watch more such videos. If you like the video, hit the like button, and do share your comments or feedbacks in the comment sections. Bye-bye.